النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says in the authentic hadith, يعني once the burial is over and it's finished, يعني in this moment that we are now, he said, ادعوا لأخيكم واسألوا له التثبيت فإنه الآن يسأل. That it is a sunnah for us now to make dua for him and ask Allah Azza wa Jal to keep him steadfast, because this is the moment in where the two angels would come down and ask him the three questions. The three very simple questions that we all know, مَنْ رَبُّكْ وَمَا دِينُكْ وَمَنْ نَبِيُّكْ, what is, who is your Lord, who is your Prophet, and what is your religion? This is the exam paper, and the answers are known. The exam, يعني, is very known. And this is the same questions that, يعني, الصحابة were asked, and the righteous were asked. And this will always be the same questions that everyone is asked up until the last day. For sunnah is to make dua that Allah Azza wa Jal keeps him steadfast when he asks and answers these questions. My brothers in Islam, after you look around here, this is the graveyard. And the only place on earth that will bring you the closest to the reality of the hereafter is the graveyard. There is nothing close to the hereafter that you'll ever imagine and see in your life other than the graveyard. This is why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith, he said that I had never ever seen something more terrifying than the sight of the grave. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, can you imagine the many things he saw in his life? And how many things did he see in his life? And yet he is the one who said that there is nothing more terrifying and horrifying than the grave I saw. For in other words, the grave is supposed to increase in a person's fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers in Islam, our brother Yusuf, ya Allah yarhamu, yani, subhanAllah, I got to know him a few months ago, yani, since Ramadan onwards. And I was there in the room just before he died, about 2 hours before he died. And I was inside, subhanAllah, qaddar Allah, yani, I was supposed to go and meet him 2 days ago. But Allah Azza wa Jal did not decree that, and it didn't happen. So yani, yesterday we said, khalas, let's go. And I went during the day. And I got there and I told the family that was around, can you hear us? They said, yes, he can hear you clear, loud and clear, no problems, but he just can't talk. So I held his hand and I said, Yusuf, squeeze my hand. He squeezed my hand. I said to him, Yusuf, raise your index finger. He raised it. So now I was sure that he was hearing me. So I began to say to him, يعني, say La ilaha illallah, say Subhanallah, say Alhamdulillah, say Allahu Akbar. But then there's one thing I want to share with you with what I said to him. And I said to him, at this moment, Yusuf, you're supposed to remember the blessings of Allah upon you. Don't think of anything bad. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لا يموتن أحدكم إلا وهو يحسن الظن بربه. Beware and do not die except that you always have good thought in Allah Azza wa Jal. Because the way you think of Allah is exactly how Allah will deal with you. So I said, Yusuf, this is the moment now in where you should not panic. And don't think bad of Allah Azza wa Jal, no matter what the past was. Think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember the blessings of Allah upon you and begin to say Alhamdulillah for each one. Hey, imagine into the day you were born. Allah Azza wa Jal made it easy for you to come out from your mother. All Alhamdulillah for that. Remember the day that you were hungry and then you found food in front of you and you began to eat. All Alhamdulillah. The day that you found Islam and you found the Tawbah and you found the righteous, yani, brotherhood, and you stuck with them, say Alhamdulillah. The day you got married, wasn't that a blessing from Allah upon you? Say Alhamdulillah. The children that you saw, all Alhamdulillah. As you do that, as you're dying, you will begin to, you can't wait now to meet the one who blessed you with all these blessings and favors. This is how a person gets himself ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yani, al-salaf rahimahumullah, they used to give advice to each other and they used to have a list. It was called, yani, sijillatul hamd. They used to have a list in where they used to write in it the blessings Allah gave them in life. And they used to make it part of their wasiyah and tell their family, when I'm dying, come and read this list to me. So I can say Alhamdulillah and I look forward to death because I'm going to go and meet the one who gave me all these blessings. Shuf Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers in Islam, yani, he's given you and he gives you so much, not because you deserve it, but because he's Al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you're always supposed to recall and reflect over this. As a result, with all these blessings, once you acknowledge them, and once you realize how much Allah has done for you in life, Allah Azza wa Jal wants from you one thing in return. And he doesn't benefit from it. You're the one that's going to benefit from it. And that is your worship, my brothers in Islam. Like Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says in the authentic hadith, that when a person dies, just like now, Yusuf died. يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتَ ثَلَاثٌ, three things follow him. أَهْلُهُ, his family, أَعْنَ ذَهِيَا. وَمَالُهُ, his wealth. What that meant is that Yani a person used to own slaves, and the slaves used to come out. That was his wealth. Nowadays, maybe his cars would come, whatever it is of his wealth would come. وَعَمَلُهُ And his righteous deeds that you and I cannot see. So two would go back, two of that which we see, which is his family, they're not going to stay here for long. Eventually they'll walk back home. And his wealth, that's going to go back as well. And it's going to be distributed. He no longer owns it. That's it. Not a single cent of it. And one thing remains in this box here. And that is عَمَلُهُ His good deeds. Fanta, you ready to go into this box with good deeds? What good deeds do you have? يعني يروى في الأثر أن there is a حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he says يوم يكون القيامة يجمع الله الأغنياء on the day of judgment Allah عز وجل he will gather all the rich everyone that had plenty of wealth in this life or businesses or mashallah he gathers them all فالله عز وجل would say to them ما شغلكم عن عبادتي what distracted you from my worship For they'll say, شغلتنا أموالنا Our wealth is our business. We had to run from one place to another. It distracted us from your worship. For Allah Azza wa Jal, He says to them, أَوَكُنْتُمْ أَغْنَى مِنْ سُلَيْمَانَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ Were you rich and you had more wealth and property than al-Malik and al-Nabi Sulaiman عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ فَإِنَّهُ مَا شَغَلَهُ مَالُهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِي His wealth and his property and everything that Allah has given him, it did not distract him from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sulaiman and his father Dawood alayhim as-salam were given as an example for us in what the best salat al-layl is. Sulaiman and Dawood alayhim as-salam would fast one day on, one day off. Yani imagine, he was a judge, and he was a king, and he was a commander, and he was a husband, and he was a father, and he was a ruler, and he was a spiritual leader, and he was a prophet. So many titles to his name. Yet nothing distracted him from dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sulaiman alayhi salam once, just once, he was distracted from Salat al-Asr. They brought out his horses. He had war horses, 20,000 of them. As-safilat al-jihad, Allah calls them in the Quran. And they were showcased before him. He was sitting down and he was yani pondering the look of these horses. For they distracted him from Salat al-Asr. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, حَتَّى تَوَارَتْ بِالْحِجَابِ Yani until the sun set and he had missed Salat al-Asr. So what did he do? Because he missed a salat in his life, he went and he said to his army, رُدُّوهَا عَلَيْهِ Bring back the 20,000 horses. فَطَفِقَ مَسْحًا بِالسُّوقِ وَالْأَعْنَابِ He beslaughtered all of them because they distracted him from one salat. And in another narration, he marked them all as horses for jihad. يعني he gave them فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ And that's it. يعني in other words, to us, it means if you are distracted from Salat al-Asr because of your car or something, you'd burn it and you'd throw it away. Who's ready to do that? That's what Sulaiman alayhi salam did. For Allah Azza wa Jal, this is how he speaks to Aghniya al-Dunya on the Day of Judgment. Then the hadith would say, ثُمَّ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الْمَرْضَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Allah Azza wa Jal would gather the sick on the Day of Judgment. And he'd say to them, مَا شَغَلَكُمْ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي What distracted you from my worship? They would say, شَغَلَنَا مَرَضُنَا Our sickness distracted you. In and out of hospital, from test to test, blood test to blood test, on the wheel, we cannot move, sick. For Allah Azza wa Jal, He says to them, أَوَكُنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ مَرَضًا مِنْ أَيُّوبَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ Were you more sick than Ayyub alayhi salam, who was bedridden for 18 years? He couldn't move. And he lost his wealth, and he lost his children, they died. And he lost his properties, and he was very rich. He lost everything. He lost the ability to move his fingers and his arms and his hand and his legs. Hatta his wife had to carry him to go to the bathroom and come back. He had a severe sickness that the entire town ran away because they feared what he had. 18 years like this. Well, hadith says, فَإِنَّهُ مَا شَغَلَهُ مَرَضُهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِي His sickness never distracted him from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Ayyub alayhi salam, no one has an excuse. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَجْمَعُ الْفُقَرَاءَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ He gathers the poor on the day of judgment. And he says to them, مَا شَغَلَكُمْ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي What distracted you from my worship? For they say, شَغَلَنَا فَقْرُنَا We were poor. We were looking for our risk. We'd go from one shop to another, one work to another. We're looking for our risk. We couldn't basically يعني spend time in your worship. For Allah Azza wa Jal would say to them, أَوَكُنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ فَقْرًا مِنْ عِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ Isa alayhi salam was very poor. Yani even he didn't even have a pillow to sleep on. He'd sleep on the rock. as the narrations would mention, فَإِنَّهُ مَا شَغَلَهُ فَقْرُهُ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي. Even his poverty and his state did not distract him from his worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then finally Allah azza wa jal, he would gather the ones that were given beauty and power in this life. يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الْأَقْوِيَاءِ on the day of judgment. And he says to them, مَا شَغَلَكُمْ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي. What distracted you from my worship? So they say, شَغَلَنَا قُوَّتُنَا وَجَمَالُنَا. Our wealth and our looks and our strength, it distracted us. We were in the gym, in and out, going in and out, doing personal training, business, whatever it is. We didn't have time for your worship. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says to them, أَوَكُنْتُمْ أَشَدَّ قُوَّةً وَجَمَالًا مِنْ يُوسُفَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. Were you more, يعني, in your strength and in your courage and in your power than Yusuf alayhi salam? فَإِنَّهُ مَا شَغَلَهُ قُوَّتُهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. Even that didn't distract him. For we find out from this hadith that at the end, you're in one of these four situations where you do not absolutely have any excuse on the day of judgment to come and say, Ya Rab, my sickness kept me away from your dhikr and from your masajid and from your ibadah. My poverty, my wealth, nothing. All of that is supposed to be an aid for a person to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, As-salatu noor. Sahih, you see the grave as being dark. You saw it, it's dark. But the only thing that's going to light this up is your salat and your Quran. أَنْزَلَّ إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا وَكِتَابًا مُبِينًا Quran. My brothers in Islam, يعني الحمد لله, we just finished 10 days of Dhul Hijjah and we finished the day of Arafah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He freed our necks from the hellfire on the day of Arafah. And we ask Allah azza wa jal that He freed our brother Yusuf from, يعني, from the hellfire as well, because the day of Arafah, as you know, it is the most day of the year in which Allah azza wa jal frees people from the fire. Alhamdulillah, he had this opportunity. My brothers in Islam, look around. These graves here aren't just plots in the grave, in the earth. They're not just holes in the earth. That's what we see them as. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Imma rawdatun min riyad al-jannah wa imma hufratan min hufar al-nar. It's either a garden of the gardens of the paradise, or it's either a pit of the pits of the fire. Really, you see them, it's not land. What's going on underneath is either fire or either the paradise. Wallahu alam how it works. But this is how Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explains it. This is why when you come to the graveyard and when you come and witness something like this, As-salaf rahimahumullah, when they used to come to the graveyard, they used to leave with a life-changing decision. This place is a place in where you make life-changing decisions. So if you never used to pray, you make the decision that you pray from now. If you used to be lazy and delay the prayers, you start praying on time. If you pray on time, then you make the decision that you're going to pray with the salat as-sunnah before and after. Then at the end of the day, this is what's going to follow you. Wallah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves all our time, all our attention. There is nothing that is supposed to distract you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially when it comes to the obligations in our deen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us, to forgive us, and to forgive our brother Yusuf. My brothers in Islam, make dua for him while you're facing the Qibla. And يعني, this is sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And before you do that, go and take the three handfuls of dirt and throw it on the grave and here, to the head side. So three handfuls and put it to the head side. Once that's finished, the truck will come down, will come back and reverse the rest of the soil in. جزاكم الله خيرا. Let's do that now. Yeah.